Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. He's the pastor who's become the face for countless protests, a gifted orator who works to inspire the next generation of world leaders. This fiery minister continues to lead the charge for racial, economic, and social justice, injustice in America. He's also one of the creative minds behind a new movie, Sinners Wanted, starring Hollywood staples like Lamon Rucker and Clifton Powell. Yes. Let's take a look.
He married a prostitute, and he has brought shame to this church.
Let me get you some help.
You don't think this is something you should have informed us about?
Yes, well, I thought it'd be best if I kept my wife's business private.
Private?
What were the charges brought up against you?
Possession of a controlled dangerous substance and prostitution.
Wow! Please welcome back down to the circle, Pastor Jamal Bryant.
Yes! Yes. Wow! Well, welcome back to the show. Edgy.
Oh,
wow, that's edgy.
Bad.
But there's a sense of care and compassion. Why is it important to show that care and compassion in this particular film?
I think the church has put itself in witness protection. Mm-hmm. That everybody who's in the church acts as if they don't have a testimony.
Mm-hmm.
You've got a whole generation that feels like they're not welcome. If you got a tattoo, if you've got piercings, if you're not wearing Chanel and St. John, and this is really the force, what is the real purpose of the church?
Mm-hmm.
Because if we're not doing outreach, then it's a country club.
Mm-hmm.
And so we've really got to do something with intentionality to get a whole nother generation involved, and they don't have to look the part to serve in the role.
Gotta meet the people where they are.
Yeah,
that's right. Absolutely.
Well, you have some very seasoned actors in this film.
Yes.
Lamar Rucker, Clifton Powell.
Yes.
Like, what immediately comes to mind when I think about, well, what dynamic do they bring to make this film come to life?
I think that they bring credibility.
Mm-hmm.
Is that we didn't want deacons in it.
Okay.
Okay. All right now.
People from the praise team, but these are people who you can identify and say, okay, I know them.
Mm-hmm.
That this gives us a passport from the street corner to the choir loft.
Mm.
And I think given that level of identifiability really lends to our credibility.
Oh,
wow.
Well, I have a really amazing question for you, but first I have to shout out my sister Tracy Braxton, who's in the, also in this film.
Yeah.
Yay!
Yeah.
Okay.
But on a more serious note, you know, in the news they've been talking about the fatal shooting of a woman by a police officer.
Yes.
And she was claiming to be pregnant and stuff at the time.
Yes.
But you having three daughters, what do you think about the police defaming and their viewership of black women in America today?
I think that the war in the nation is against women.
Mm.
When you look at what has happened in Alabama recently, that whether it's because of incest or rape, the government gets to make a decision over a woman's body. And I think that the assault is the silence of the church on the assault of women. Is that here we are in 2019 and you've got some churches that won't let women preach, but you'll let them cook chicken.
Right.
It's okay for you to be a liturgical dancer but can't be a deacon.
Right.
And so I think that the greatest frontier of sexism is in the church.
Mm.
And if we don't really confront it there, then we really have a muted voice to talk about where it is in society.
You better
I didn't even think of it in that.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Think about how many times our mothers or aunts had to do announcements but had to do it from the floor.
Mm-hmm.
But couldn't come up. They wouldn't make them pastors, but they got to be evangelist trainer. But can never be pastor trainer.
Right.
So we've got to really do a real come to Jesus meeting.
Literally.
To figure out where it is that we are. Nobody in America thought Hillary Clinton was smarter than Trump. But it was just veiled sexism to say, I'd rather take somebody with no discipline, no focus, and no thought than take a woman who is competent.
This entire segment is a message. Pastor Bryant, as someone who's been on the front lines in the fight for justice for several years, What is the temperature of your team? Yes. You know what I'm saying? And how can, you know, what are some of the steps that you guys can take to help onlookers mm-hmm. be just as vigilant as you are and trying to, you know, come outreach, go out into the communities as well to help create change?
Right. Here's the issue. Most of us around the table are in the same age demographic. And what I try to say to what I call the civil rights era mm-hmm. is it's easier for them to say fight on because they had victories. Mm-hmm. So they were able to drink at the water fountain, get in the bathroom, eat at the lunch counter. We got to ask, what victories have we been able to establish? Mm-hmm. Nobody went to jail for Trayvon Martin. Nobody went to jail for Sandra Bland. Nobody went to jail for Michael Brown. And none of us believe that this officer in Texas who shot this pregnant woman mm-hmm. Is really going to pay the penalty. And so we've got to raise it up. So what happens when you've got post-traumatic stress yeah. mm-hmm. for fighting for justice?
Right. Mm-hmm.
There is no retreat center. There is no group therapy. We just got to keep going. Mm-hmm. And so that's why you saw the synergy around Nipsey Hussle, mm-hmm. Because everybody was saying, this is us
yeah.
Dying trying to do well.
Yes.
How many young activists in Ferguson and St. Louis have gone missing or found dead under mysterious circumstances with no FBI investigation?
Yes. Do you think that the activist, the role of the activist has changed and there's a misunderstanding about what that is in America?
Yeah, the role of the activists has changed is because you're dealing with a generation that's not looking for a national organization cover. So this is not the NAACP, it ain't the Urban League, it's not SCLC, mm-hmm. it's Twitter.
Right.
They saying meet us downtown at 12 and that's
right.
it.
Right.
And so I think it's organically coming together, and so the church has got to get on the train. And here's the difficulty, is this the very first time the black church has to be a part of a movement they don't lead.
Mm. Oh, okay.
So we're not the spokespeople, but we've got to be the supporters.
My goodness, we could talk to you all day. And for clarity, I just was reminded by our producer that the woman who was shot in Texas was not pregnant. So just wanted to give you that clarity. But thank you so much, Pastor Jamal Bryant. We appreciate you. You know we could talk to you all day, but we have a lot more to talk about here on the show. Please check out his new film, Sinners Wanted, and Select Theaters on May 31st. So